There, my friends, and welcome back to the kingdom of Nenetsia and its powerful vassals that try to take over islands, chiefdoms, and continents. We are not, until now. Maybe we need to declare war. Chief Weingashi of Bjarmia, who wants to take our jarldom from us. That cannot be tolerated. We'll send our marshal, the Jarl Thorstein of Mezen, Bjarmia, we'll try to imprison him now. Let's wait a little. Now it's a lot better chance. See how many troops he has. 1,000. Thankfully, we have our troops ready here. Ormr, we have Bertil. And how about Haraldr? We're not kind of a good commander. But we'll prepare to join in. With Runvald, the Jarl of Severod. Let's imprison him. Guards failed to capture Chief Weingashi, who has now raised his flag in rebellion. To arms! How many are there? Oh, we are fighting already. They have surrendered. Had a victory against the Bjarmia tribe. And now, wahoo! That's a crazy amount. We'll move over. Can negotiate with Arnfast of Arnfast's host. They want no. I'm not gonna sell our vassals' counties. They may be plundered. Look at that. No. Take that down. Oh, Bjarmia is a fine county indeed. Having invested myself in this literary endeavor, we're writing a book, I've been feeling drained lately. Scribes ask me what next section of the book should be about, I should throw my hands out in the air. Should I know? You cannot rush these things. I need inspiration. What? Perhaps I'll indulge in some late night festivities with my soldiers. Nah. I could probably ask Faste for some kind of draught. They'll just need a break. No, I mean, we're diligent. We're not content. We're temperate, but we're temperate, we'll not go for the festivities. We will ask Faste for some kind of draught. We're vomiting right now. My goodness. We're really, really into this book. Need to seek treatment for the vomiting. Master of Uppsala has worried you are infected with a bubonic plague. He insists that you follow his instructions very well. Our vomiting has finally stopped and you can start eating regular meals again. I feel better. Balance your own humors. Buster made you sprint around your keep to induce sweating. Very nice. Let's hope we don't have a bubonic plague. Your seer, a wife, has been discovered charging money for various religious favors, putting the gold in her own pocket. Disappointing, but I mean, she's our wife. She's our wife. We must ignore it. We could imprison her. No. No, not at all. Never. Never imprison our wife. We have won the tribe. What does he want? He surrenders. Is that what we also get here? Imprisoned loses prestige. Yeah, we'll accept. Revolt has ended. We won. Let's revoke this title. He's a traitor. There are things that you cannot do, even with a benevolent ruler. Let's look what is going on there. Is anyone targeting us? I mean, this guy wants to target our Jarl. Chief Sudbia of Canin. He won't end the plot. Maybe that is, yeah, I mean, it's probably a good idea to try to stop him as well. And the marshal will of course do that. Northampton was, what, how many? What is that? Cathar uprising. What has happened here? Our marshal, yeah, and our marshal, as he is affected, goes here. Let's see what advances we can induce. Let's see. I mean, being tolerant is certainly very good for us. Being more majestic is too. Religious customs, maybe, but we have not really that many. So I think we'll go for tolerance, because we're generally, at least we were relatively benevolent. And so there's that, right? Then let's see, we have economy advances. What could we go for? Improved keeps, be good. Castle infrastructure. Yeah, I mean, that would be good. Church infrastructure, we have no real things there, so we haven't had too many walls, so let's go for castle infrastructure. Make our castle better. Military advances. We could make our cavalry better, or have better siege equipment. Make the cavalry a little bit better. We'll move here with the army. Of course, that's the next traitor who won't end his plot. Yeah, we cannot help you though. The problem. Now we're here. We'll try to imprison him because he's the leader of a plot. Let's wait 1 month. Now. Here we go. He managed to avoid my guardsmen and has fled to the court of High Chief Nabitko. In cunning. In cower, in fear. Nabitko is... And now we have Chief Karuchi of Kanin here. Yeah, well, okay. That's at least a little better. We won't end the plot still. Well, there's nothing we can do, unfortunately. Björn Raffelsson. Where is that guy? In Uleaborg, okay. Nah. And this guy wants to kill... the commander of Indiga. Our vassal or what? It kind of is. So, the chief of Indiga. Goodness. Always trying to kill someone, aren't they? He wants to kill his own heir. What kind of sense does that make? And he also has that Sjudbia cuckweed here. Cannot imprison though. Let's go here, split up. Siege of Crowland. Oh, that's again in England. It's really terrible, but we cannot do anything. Split that army now. Move away. Not with Bragi though. Bertil. Lead them away as quickly as you can. To Bjarmia. Oh, my concubine Gudrun is also pretty. That's very nice. She's also chaste like we are, so she's our favorite. She's frail though. Hope this doesn't lead to a bad child. Not a bad, another sickly child. My liege, a loyal servant such as I surely deserves some recognition. Raymond of Rouen, the spymaster, chief of Rouen. Was the county of Onega Peninsula? Be happy to grant you this deserved reward, but no. You are in Rouen. What do you want here? Brithild seeks to kill Ormer of Savaroth. He wants to kill Ormer of Savaroth. That isn't that one of our commanders? Can't do anything against that. And he wants to marry Princess Asta the Heavenly, King Gelder of Denmark. Asta is such a beautiful shield maiden in the making. Ah, we're sad to see her go, but he's really a good one. We'll accept. Can we have some kind of pact then? An aggression pact or something? Apparently not. Goodness, we have no court physician. What has happened to Faste? Let's recruit a court physician. I've sent messengers and scouts out in all directions to scout the realm for skilled physicians. That will be helping to... We need to take up residence in your court. Word should reach you shortly if they manage to find a suitable candidate. Hopefully, they will not bring back a quacksalver. Pastor has died, and then... No, let's cancel that. We need to go to Kuloy and improve our hospital then. Let's build that sick house, finally. Here we go. The spymaster Simon reports that a heretical sorcerer has been caught and jailed in the city of Arc. Heretical sorcerer? What are you talking about? He's a good man. He's cruel, though. This sorcerer has apparently healed various ailments afflicting the other prisoners. Although he's scheduled for execution at Dune, you could pardon him and bring him to your employ. He's a genius, a knave appeaser, shy, proud, and cruel. A combination of a man. Temperate, diligent, honest. I don't know, is that... Would we do such a thing? A heretical sorcerer. I don't know. I mean, we feel we are benevolent. Let's roll this out. That's 1, 2, 3. That's 4, 5, 6. We've got a 3, so most unorthodox, but I do need a physician. Word of an epidemic. We have received news of an epidemic in the Western Protectorate. Information is vague, but word is people are dying like flies, and the fear of disease is spreading as fast as the affliction itself. Furthermore, the condition is reported irreversible as well as incurable, and the scattered records of the events are worrisome. No source of evil revealed. People are turning to their gods and on each other to protect themselves from contagion. Many call it a plague. Knew this would happen. Where's the plague? Is there a plague or what? First, there's the plague of deserts. There is some kind of fever here down there, and a slow fever, a camp fever. Black Death is coming. We probably don't know that. Really, yeah. We only know the rumors, but we don't know where it is. And thankfully, we've already started to build a new sick house. Congratulating ourselves on being so diligent about this. Yeah, we've got another tribe. Good stuff. Oh, it's Ulfgeir. He's no longer sickly. Party of Murre has been converted to the Germanic faith. Oh, you're doing so well. Saga Skrungholzdottir, our half-sister, has arrived at our court with her husband, Skuli Ketilsson. He really likes us. He really likes us. He's a good man. He's strong. Could be a great commander. We have Sturbjörn, also arrived at our court. As a little man and detached priest. Katarina, a lowborn hunchback. Skuli, yeah, we already had Skuli. Let's have a look at our court, though, again. We always try to marry people. Alfred's our concubine, though. Is that true? Is he our concubine? No. He's very exotic. And she wants to marry. Yeah. Which people do want to marry? Gudrun wants to marry a ruler. Gunhild, our concubine, wants to marry a ruler. Sigrid wants to marry. Linda wants to marry. And Hrodulf wants to marry. Maybe they'll make the perfect match, right? With Hrodulf. Here we go. Then we've got, oh my god, she has great pox, we will not marry her. Anyone? But Astrid of Winchester and Harald of Nenetia. Of Harald of Kuloy. Astrid. Oh, the other Astrid. That could be dangerous, but who knows? Concubines always want to marry a ruler. Yeah, they want to marry us. A daughter was born to us. Princess Gudrun named Gida. Okay. Ah. What will she be like? See? 7. Oh, she'll learn a heritage. But nothing special. Oh, and Onega Peninsula has been converted to the Germanic faith. So good for us. Because now, already have a stone hill fort. We can now build a new holding. No, we really wanted to convert this into a castle right now. Do that now? Yeah, we can upgrade it into a castle. There we go. Very nice. Now Onega has been converted. So good. We're good for it. Let's give it some castle fortifications to celebrate this. And we'll send our wife further to the Bjarmia tribe. Protected by the army. Growing ever more powerful. Look how many people we have there. Waitable for combat should that arise, but it probably will not. Prince Alfgeir. The question is, what should we do? Should we now send our concubines away? Was it too early? Do we still feel he's sickly? Maybe. At age 4, we'll wait until he's kind of a young man, and then we'll send the concubines away. Maybe we'll have a look at the concubines. He's 23, 34, 39. Maybe Gunhild. Set her aside. She wants to marry a ruler. We'll arrange a marriage for her. With whom? I mean, she wants to marry, and we have no ruler for her, unfortunately. Let's find her some kind of ruler, right? What do we have here? Faste. His heir. Let's see that she gets someone. But Bercy wants to marry. Well, he's not a ruler, but he's fresh, kind, he's well groomed. He'll probably like it. Better than nothing. We'll find another concubine. Our kinswoman, another princess of Nenetsia. She's frail, though. We're kind of warned against that. We need a tribalist. Hello, tribalist. Aslaug, the heavenly. she's dull, but that's not really something we see as a problem. Alfred of Snooker. Princess Aslaug the Heavenly. Maybe we are also kind of drawn to her, right? She's a fellow tribalist. She knows that we must do something. She's also chastity. She understands what we are making through, what we're going through. And so, we're closing this for now. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. We'll see each other next time and we'll find out if the little Alfgeir survives and if we can convert more, because it's very important to spread the word of Odin to the world. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. This is Immanuel Kahn, signing out. Until next time.